Hello, Bryan Adams High School. They're probably thinking, oh my gosh, she is so weird. My name is Amber Wiest, and I am a working actress here in Chicago. I am a comedian, stand-up improviser. I'm also actress, so we got Shakespeare contemporary plays. I'm a painter, a singer. I just do it all. I live in the city, and so during this entire interview, we're going to be hearing a lot of city sounds, and we're not going to get scared about it. So don't be afraid, it's just Chicago. My main thing right now is I am at Second City. Some of our alumni are Tina Fey, Amy Poehler, Stephen Colbert, Stephen Carell, Chris Farley. We got a lot of the, all the comedy greats. Terrifying and amazing to be a part of it. I'm living for this. I'm really excited to talk to you guys. So, question number one. What was your first professional job? My first professional job, I was an acting apprentice with the Florida Studio Theater down in Sarasota, Florida. And that was a really fun experience doing an internship because I went as an actress, but I also was plugged into all sorts of places in the theater as well. We did work in marketing and development, house management. We were there building sets, taking down sets. Basically, everything that I learned about in high school and college really came into play. So that really made me a much more well-rounded individual, which was fun. Next question. When you got your career, did it meet your expectations? Absolutely, and a little bit more all the time. For me, a philosophy that I've always lived by is, what is that one thing that you want to be doing when you have nothing else to do? That is probably the realm that you should go ahead and make your career. So for me, it was singing and acting and playing make-believe and all that fun stuff. So I just made that my career. I just kind of cheated and said, you know what, I'm gonna do that for my whole life because I have to. What I expected from a career in theater was that we're gonna always be jumping at opportunities. We're gonna create opportunities for ourselves, be it auditioning or finding that job. And so far, that's exactly what I've been doing. Let's see, what is the coolest theater experience you have seen? We have a theater here called the Chicago Shakespeare Company. They recently just did a production called Mary Stuart. And so that's gonna be a story about the beautiful rivalry, super juicy stuff between the Queen of England and the Queen of Scots. It was so much fun. Like the stage opened up and then there was a water element that they played with, and just everything was so seamless and really, really fun. And since I've been focusing more on, you know, really minimalistic sets as far as comedy is concerned, that was really cool. It was really cool to watch. What is the coolest theater experience you have done as part of a job? When I was in Florida with the Florida Studio Theater, we did we took our children's show called The Velveteen Rabbit out on tour. That was a really, really fun experience because we would load up everything into a tour van. Cast was in charge of all sorts of stuff, so we had a lot of responsibility, which was nice. Good learning experience, and we would tour around Florida to take the show to different elementary schools. That was a really fun experience. So you really had to be ready for when everything goes wrong. What are you gonna do? Especially because it's for kids. They pick up on every little thing that's going wrong. They will point and stare and scream, and you gotta roll with it. So it was a lot of improv that I learned. How did you get seen or heard? Well, as you can probably tell from how much I ramble, I have no problem with saying, hey, here I am, you're gonna love me, here we go. Which is what you have to do, especially when you're in any creative field. You have to go out into the world and make your opportunities for yourself. With Second City, I started with being a waitress with their company, and even getting that job, I would email like every other day, call all the time, say, did you get my resume? Did you get my resume? And then finally it just started showing up in person and they probably thought I was crazy. And then eventually they just gave me the interview. And then once I was a waitress at Second City, I started meeting all these people on faculty and staff there, started talking to actors and connections there, and pretty soon just started climbing the ladder. And so I'm a huge believer in you make your own way. Never wait around for somebody else to tell you you're gonna do something. You're just gonna go out there and do it yourself. If you weren't in your career, what would you do? This sort of ties around back to my idea of, if you aren't doing what you truly love in this world, eventually you're gonna kind of be miserable, right? And so, and I think there's gonna be highs and lows in any career, so you might as well do what you love while you experience the highs and lows in life. So luckily, if I wasn't in my career, I would probably still be doing the same things. I don't think there's anything else that I would be doing, to be honest, because I wanted to make sure that I chose something that I can just fall madly in love with for my whole life. Oh my gosh. What should we expect if we decide to pursue theater as a career? You're gonna have to work so hard to make this happen. And you are going to have to push yourself. You're gonna have to find so much self-discipline and so much self-motivation. You have to be your biggest cheerleader and just, my favorite Jim Carrey quote is just, you have to have insane belief that this is going to happen. Your dreams have to become plans, and you have to get really realistic and what you have to do today, right now, to get to that place later. That's gonna be the hardest part of this. It's not gonna be landing that audition. It's not gonna be getting that agent. All of that's pretty easy. The hard part is making sure that you stay the hard worker, the insane person who's going over to that company every day until they let you in. But what I can promise you, beyond any other answer I could possibly try to string together right now, if you put in that hard work for yourself, you will see things start to happen for you. Obviously, you guys are talented. Obviously, you have something to share with the world because you made it this far in life, and here you are, ready to take on the world. If you take those little tiny steps and you just don't ever quit, don't ever stop working, opportunities are gonna happen, and you're gonna get rewarded for that. And then you're gonna get famous, and then you're gonna get an Oscar, and it's gonna be so much fun. Okay, maybe no Oscars, but you're gonna find your jobs, and you're gonna find your shows, and your life will change forever, and it's gonna be really, really great. What does your typical day look like? When I was an intern, my day was packed from 6 a.m. all the way until like 1 or 2 a.m. It was constant within one single theater company. And it was a lot of work, but what was kind of nice about that is someone else was in charge of my schedule. And so I had to do a show in the morning up to the offices and work with marketing and development kind of early afternoon, go work in the box office in the late afternoon, and then be a house manager for the main stage shows at night. Very structured, very fun, and I liked that. But then a big part of me wanted to kind of go and become in charge of my own schedule, have the flexibility of being able to go to any company that I wanted to. And so once my internship was done, I moved up here to Chicago, and now my days are different almost every day because it's all up to me, to what I want to do. As I said, I'm a waitress at the restaurant at Second City. That's how I'm paying my bills. I'll look at a week and I'll know, okay, I'm working Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday nights, and the rest of the time is up to me. And so that's where that self-motivation has to come in if you're really gonna make this work. I will be researching auditions, researching stand-up open mics at the Laugh Factory, at Zany's, wherever, and I'm booking my own stuff. I'm being my own agent right now. And then I'm rehearsing, I'm researching, I'm studying Shakespeare. So that's what my days look like now. They're a little bit more flexible, which is nice. How long did it take you to get where you are? For me, my internship happened right when I got out of college, and then I decided to move here to Chicago immediately after that. So this has only been about 4 years or so. It's been because I've been relentless in my work ethic, and I've demanded a lot from myself. As far as the theater world, we don't really look at how long things take, we look at where you want to be. And then we sort of place those goals out ahead of us, and then we just start chasing them. How much do you get paid? Nothing. No, I've done a lot of paid gigs. My internship, we weren't paid all that much, but we were given room and board, so that was cool. Almost all of my gigs right now are gonna be like $50, $100, $250, but you really do have to do your side gigs. What I kind of consider my theater career just for a while is going to be doing those silly part-time jobs that you sadly get really good at, and they're kind of boring and they're whatever. That's gonna be paying the bills, and you're doing your art because you just can't help it. eventually, something like at the Second City, we have classes and then we have our main stages. You can audition to get onto those main stages, and once you do, that's gonna be a salary. That's gonna be like a yearly thing, and so that's where all the money comes in, and you can quit Jimmy John's and live your life. But even before you get to those gigs, you're having so much fun that you kind of don't mind doing all your part-time jobs because you're just doing what you love. So it's fine. I do this all the time, and I'm annoying myself, so I'm really sorry about that. How stressful is it to be in theater? It's a slippery slope, to be honest. It's a big mind game. There's a reason we call it drama. You can walk into an audition and see a million people all lined up, and they even have the same outfit as you. And you can decide, I'm against them, I'm never gonna get this, oh my goodness. Likewise, in the tech side of things, you can be looking at a stack of resumes like this, and they've all done that musical set, and they've all done that amazing rigging thing that you did. And you can think the world's out to get you, and there's no place for you, and you can just go crumbling. Or you can remember, we're all in theater together. So I think once you kind of really unify this theater world, the stress goes away. It's not me against you. It's not that resume versus that one. We're just all trying to create art, and that's very freeing. And so as long as you can just free yourself and realize that you're just in this because you have to be and you're creating something, the stress will go away. It's gonna be fine. How often do you get a job offer? Constantly, because I'm constantly making my own job offers. Especially if you move to big cities like LA, Chicago, Minneapolis, Dallas, which is quite close to you. New York City, of course, all sorts of big mecca cities. There's gonna be 50 auditions, 50 jobs needed every month. And it's up to you to go grab them, to go claim them. So luckily in the theater world, we're never gonna have a job scarce kind of a moment. You might get bogged down in your own brain and kind of decide that you have no motivation to go out and get them. That could happen, but the jobs are always there, which is awesome. Did you struggle to make a living in the theater? No, but that's because I'm crazy. I'm just so obsessed with making my own way. It's not so much of a struggle to me, and I very much expected it to be really, really hard. And so when I got out here and I realized, yeah, you gotta hustle. It's not really a struggle because it's kind of what I expected it to be. What was your first play? So I was the dog in Annie when I was in middle school, but I don't think you're asking about my middle school career. My first professional gig was with that internship. And so it was a children's play, and I played all sorts of characters, like a narrator, a pirate, all sorts of stuff. And now that I'm in comedy, I'm playing me, which is hard. I rather play a pirate sometimes. Sometimes it's fun to be yourself, but it's kind of scary. Was the journey worth it? Yes, 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 yes. P.S. You're gonna find a life journey whether you pick theater or not, and so you might as well be doing what you love while you're on your journey. The journey's not over by any means, but the journey that I've been taking up until now completely formed me as a person. The good and the bad. I think sometimes the bad things in the journey are almost more worth it because that's where you really learn your entire being. Okay, so those are the questions and those are my answers. From listening to all of your questions, what I'm really hearing from you guys is like, is this gonna be worth it? Can I make it happen? You're going to live your life, right? Another theme I'm getting is this gonna be hard? Yes, this is gonna be very, very hard and difficult, but I feel like anything that's worth doing is also gonna be very difficult. I think the number one thing is that just constantly believe in yourself and believe that this is going to happen. Things will just start happening, doors are gonna start opening. And remember that failure, they say that failure isn't an option, and it so is, and sometimes you have to, so that way you can find out, oh, I was supposed to go that way. Don't be afraid of making the wrong choices. I think as long as you learn from every mistake in life, it's not a mistake anymore. You're gonna come out into this theater ocean and realize there are some currents and treading water gets a little tiresome, but we are all in this together, and so you're gonna find so many people and so many resources to really help you through this. I am one of them. I'm gonna leave my contact information with you guys. And so if you have any more questions, please reach out to me, because I'm going to be one of those life rafts for you, as you're going to find all over the place. We're a very supportive career choice. The last thing I'm going to leave you on, you know what you want to do with this life. You know deep down. And go ahead and listen to that voice, because it's probably the right one. And if you really truly don't know, just make sure that you're doing something that you love until you find out. Because life is going to find a way to let you know what you need to do. Bryan Adams High School, we're ready. We're cool. We're good. And like I said, if there's anything else you have questions on, do not hesitate to come get me, okay? You got this. Love you. Bye.